Hi, welcome back to Bazaar Corporate Radar. For now, the market is looking okay, in fact, holding up above that 11,000 mark. Zee Entertainment is making a big comeback, by the way. It fell to a low of 318 when that crisis hit it. Now it's back to 390 almost. So maybe short covering rally there. But let's do one thing. Let's get some more views on board. DMart Retail saw a smart revenue growth in the third quarter as the festive season has boosted the revenues. EBITDA margins, however, declined on the back of higher employee costs and other expenses. Lalit Agarwal, the chairman and managing director of V-Mart Retail, joins in now. Mr. Agarwal, thanks for joining us and congratulations on a good set of numbers. I just want to get the, you know, bad news out of the way. On the margin front, there was a bit of a decline on the back of higher employee and other expenses. What kind of trajectory do you see this 10% margins that you've clocked in for the full year so far in 9 months, 10 to 11%, is that a band that you can maintain for the rest of the fiscal?
Yeah, good morning. Thank you so much for the appreciation. We have been able to do away with, you know, in spite of not so great 9 months, but still we have been able to contain the margin, and I think it should be positive and should look better going forward. The margin scenario should be good. We have seen all such kind of days, because this last quarter at least the festivals impacted the sales, where you get the best of the margins in this particular quarter. So third quarter is typically the best quarter. We should be able to cruise through the similar margins in the rest of the time period in the year.
Okay. I just wanted to know whether post the festival season, Mr. Agarwal, have sales looked better than they looked in the same period last year? Is there incremental growth, footfalls?
Not so great. Festival was really very good. Post the festival, we haven't seen that big growth or jump in the year-on-year sales performance or the footfall coming up. We have seen some softness in the market, even in the month of January or in the December month. So that is a small concern, but I think it's going to take over in this particular month because of a lot of weddings and then coming up with a new festival of Holi in the month of March. So we will have lot of buzz around that, and then lot of soaps from the government on the budget, which is making consumer feel better. So I think that feeling will bring in some more cheers and then increase the margin.
Your press release had a sentence: the company is invested in ramping up its warehousing capacity and strengthening its talent pool at all levels. What does this mean? What is the capex involved? And what exactly do you mean by ramping up your talent pool? Will employee costs go up? Will margins therefore be affected in the immediate run?
Yeah, you see, because we see a huge opportunity in Indian market and there are a lot of markets and there is a lot of potentiality for us to grow. So we are looking at this is a very, very long-term strategy. So we want to build the right capability in the organization so that we can address not only this quarter's or this year's growth numbers, but we should sustain this for the next 5 years. So that's the whole plan the company is trying to build up in its infrastructure, capability development, analytics, digitalization, whatever it is. So I think we are regularly investing on that area. We want to keep on investing in that area in building capability at the manpower side. Also motivating them enough, because we had a ESOP scheme which we declared, and then there was some effect which came in because of ESOP also on the expenses part. So we would have keep doing that, because this is how we will be trying to build the organization where everyone should have the ownership and the motivation to take the organization to the 5x of what we are today.
Sure. I just want some more numbers. Your same store sales growth in this quarter was 11%. Is that something that you can maintain in Q4 and in FY20 as well? And are you seeing more demand come in from tier 3, tier 4 cities as compared to, the larger ones?
Yeah, we have seen a mixed response. Third quarter, at least, we didn't see too much of coming in from tier 3, tier 4. We saw a lot coming in from even tier 2 and tier 1. But I think normally we are very strong in tier three. That has been always a good market for us. So we have seen some of the markets not growing as what we expected them to grow. During festivals, yes, we saw tier three, tier four booming, and then they really gave us a huge growth. But you know, otherwise in the seasonal requirement, when there were a few weddings in November and December, the markets went down a little bit, because they normally behave on the festivals and those occasions when they want to wear or when there is a need. So that's how the small markets behave. So that I think will come back in this particular quarter. As far as the same store sales growth is concerned, we have had a very healthy same store sales growth in the last quarter, 11%, because of also a lot of festivals falling in quarter three. We may not see almost similar, but we aspire to go around that. But I don't know, the January month didn't seem too great, but yes, I think we should be able to have a moderate same store sales growth. May not be the 11%, but
all right, Lalit, we'll leave it there today. Thanks a lot for joining us. That's V-Mart stock down about 0.5%. Tech Mahindra really is the one to watch out for now. Just crossed 800 on the futures, that stock, on the cash market, 796. So 6% move on that stock. Dish TV is up 8%. So that's short covering, of course. Zee Entertainment as well. SRF, which came out with good numbers but didn't react yesterday, is reacting today. So that's interesting. That one is up about 4% in trade today. Ashwani Gujral and Mitesh Thakkar back with us. Prakash Gaba also with us in our studios. Good morning again. Ashwani, holding 11,000 till now, your thoughts and your stock calls?
Well, just about. And you know, the train should have left the station by now. The other problem is that again, you have 600 advances and 830 decliners, and only IT is doing well. My sense is that once this IT rally is over, there's very little holding up the market. In fact, all ADAG, all Adani, everything is now collapsing. So that way, you know, keep a 20-point type of stop and expect the rally to fail. So probably we need to give it another half an hour, 45 minutes to see how sustainable this is. But on individual stocks, ICICI Bank is a buy with a stop of 350. Three target of 367. Jubilant Food is a sell with a stop of 1290, target of 1250. And Adani Enterprise is a sell with a stop of 122, target of 110.
Okay, well, there are plenty of stocks that are hitting a new 52-week highs today, whether it's Tech Mahindra, Axis Bank, Infosys, Wipro, even something like a UPL. You know, it was in this band of 720 to 750 for very long, UPL that is, and now it's broken above that. It's gotten to past 800, a new 52-week high there. Mitesh Thakkar and Prakash Gaba are also with us. Gentlemen, morning. Mitesh, what would your call be? The index is holding above 11,000. Individual stock ideas?
So we have taken some long positions on the index with a stop below 10,975. And I think, you know, if the breakout succeeds, then I'm looking at targets of around 11,080 to 11,100 to begin with, maybe 11,200 on the upside. The calls I have right now are a buy on Tata Alexa with a stop at 892 for targets of 928. And Asian Paints is something which I like a lot. And I think that's also an intraday chart showing good traction on the upside. It's moved up slightly, but around 1465 can be bought with a stop below 1450 for targets of 1495. And Tech Mahindra, my bias remains kind of positive. It was a top pick. I said chase it even after the gap up opening. I think 840, 845 is the next area where the stock can head towards.
Okay, Prakash, good morning again. What would you trade the index at all?
Good morning, Lata. Well, so far the trend is still intact up, has not been compromised. The technical targets beyond 11,000 is 11,084. I think it's going there as a matter of time. So if you get a dips are buying opportunities. Dips until 10,950 are buying opportunities if you're playing a few days up. I have two stocks and both on the long side. I'll go with Hero Motors. That's certainly looking good to me. Uptrend is continuing, and the momentum that you saw yesterday was more of a consolidation. So I think it's heading up to levels closer to around 3,000 zones. Hero Motors stop below 2,800 should be okay. And I like the good old Reliance. Reliance certainly is looking good. Seen a good up move. Momentum pull is there. It has to go to 1350 zones. If the market has to go up, Reliance has to go up. Reliance can take it on its single shoulders out there. So 1350 is the target for it. Stop below 1286 on Reliance should be okay.
All right, gentlemen, thanks a lot for joining us. So those are some technical calls. But let's get back to the fundamentals now. Whirlpool saw a very strong top line growth this time around in the third quarter, but it's the margins which were the key disappointment. Sunil D'Souza, who's the MD of Whirlpool of India, joins us now to talk about that. Sunil, hi, good morning, and thanks for joining us. You know, that's been the key trend across the industry, margin pressure in the consumer durable space in Q3. It may be because of competitive pressures, but is that something that is just a one-quarter phenomenon, or do you think that we can expect more margin pressure in the quarters to come?
Yeah, before I comment on the margin specifically, I'd like to say, I mean, Whirlpool, we've registered the 13th quarter of growth. You saw a strong top line in the quarter, 27% growth, and the bottom line at 61 crores PAT was again a 14% growth. So all in all, we think we delivered a good quarter, but the quarter was quite eventful in terms of the festival season entirely shifting and therefore the demand cycle changing. But we also saw a lot of blips on the macroeconomic environment in terms of commodities. And the key point I would like to highlight is the volatility that we saw. Mm. Oil hit a four-year high. The rupee was at a 74. Duties changed. I think the volatility during a peak demand cycle created an issue. We could not take pricing because we had to be very judicious. We could not take all the pricing that we planned for because we had to be judicious not to disrupt the demand which was out there with the festivals. But that said, I think a lot of that is behind us now. We're seeing commodities and rupee at a high compared to last year, but at a stable trend. It is not as volatile as we saw last quarter, number one. Number two, I think demand will sort of stabilize right now. Pricing actions have been taken, new products have been launched. So I would say we would see margins coming back in this quarter. If you take the 9 months for a more longer period, I think we saw a 14% top line in the last 9 months, and we've seen a 16% bottom line. So margins have actually come positive. And we would do expect that with our plans in place, I would see an improvement in margins this quarter.
Okay. Can you give us some color on how things are at the moment, Sunil? You did say that there was a lot of volatility in the quarter gone by. But lately, in the last two, three months, we have seen a fair degree of stability in crude prices and in commodity prices. So is fourth quarter looking like shaping up better?
Yeah, as I mentioned, I think it is not the movements per se, it is the volatility
exactly.
When it happens, which troubles the industry.
Mm.
Yeah, so we are seeing, rupee like right now is a 71, 72 compared to about 60 to 63 last year at the same period, but it's in a specific band. Same thing with oil, it's about a $60, $62 and again operating in a band. And therefore, it is quite easy for us to predict the cost of production as we move forward and take pricing and make sure that our product lineup is strong. That's one piece. The second piece is we do see demand holding out as of now, though we see a disparate this thing in growth. We see tier 2, tier 3 firing quite strongly and growth, but not to that level in the urban and metro areas.
Mm.
We're quite bullish about the way this budget has brought in stuff, put the money into the hands of the middle class consumers, tax slab gone from 2.5 to 5, and I think the finance minister himself said that if you plan it right, maybe up to a 6.5 lakhs, you don't have to pay tax. MSPs have gone in, direct benefits to farmers. So we do see more liquidity in the hands of the consumers.
Sure.
The GDP holding out, inflation remaining low, so we see demand also holding out, so we are expecting good times.
So Sunil, if you can just drill it down to the specifics in terms of revenue growth, among ACs, refrigerators, washing machines, etc., where do you see the highest revenue growth or volume growth come in over the next few quarters?
We are primarily focused on refrigerators and washers. That's the biggest part of our portfolio, but we also play in other categories like microwaves, air conditioners, water purifiers,
mm.
and now the cooking business.
Mm.
We see growth across the portfolio, but stronger growth probably coming in the penetration categories. The first time buyer of an appliance is a refrigerator buyer. That's the first appliance which is going in, and that's our strength in the market.
Okay.
The second is normally a washer. That again, we are quite strong. So we see that. Third is cooking. With the Elica deal in place right now, we see trajectory on cooking.
Okay.
So we do see demand coming in stronger in categories in which we are stronger. But that said, like I mentioned, we do see appliance growth across all the different segments.
Okay. So Sunil, from what you're saying, you said that tier 2, tier 3 is showing more traction and not so much in tier 1. So should we understand, can you give us some color on whether the higher value washers and refrigerators are being demanded or the entry level?
So growth is across the portfolio, but there is stronger growth that we are seeing on penetration. We've always maintained India as a penetration market, and as GDP grows, penetration will grow. And I think we are starting to see that play out right now.
I take your point on penetration.
As I said,
I take your point on penetration. What I'm asking is, would a 40,000 rupee fridge be more in demand than a 70,000 rupee fridge?
As a overall appliance portfolio, normally the lower end pricing is a bigger market than the higher piece. And because we are seeing this faster growth, we would see a shift in mix. I would say the mass and mass premium segments would probably be growing faster than premium.
Okay.
But that said, for Whirlpool specifically, I think we've got more of a share opportunity in premium.
Okay.
And therefore, you would probably see a balanced growth from our side. But from an industry side, premium, I would expect a slower growth.
Okay.
There would be a growth. It would not be a decline. But we do see slightly slower growth there.
Can you give us a specific number for the air conditioner segment? Because the last time we spoke with you, you said you're hopeful of double-digit revenue growth for the full year in the AC business. What have you done so far? And what kind of volume growth do you see going ahead?
Yeah, so first of all, in the December quarter, we did see double-digit AC growth. So AC growth did come back. But that said, if I take the whole year, last year was an eventful year. Because ACs, India penetration is about 4 to 5%, and therefore it is still highly temperature dependent and disposable income dependent. We did see a lot of variations in temperature, and that impacted ACs as a whole industry last year. But if the weather holds out this year, we do see a strong demand coming back into the industry. And I think someone did an analysis, and I was reading about it, that ACs is quite a cyclical business. Every alternate year or every 2 years, the industry just takes off. I do expect the 2019 calendar year to be a year of takeoff. We have strengthened our portfolio, both for the entry points as well as the premium piece, having launched several new products, and making sure that we've expanded our reach with key retailers to make sure we're taking advantage of this demand out there.
All right. We'll leave it at that, Sunil. Thank you very much for joining us and giving us a lot of nuances on the consumer appliances place in general and Whirlpool's in particular. We'll take a break. We'll come back and take a check on the commodity space. We'll also take a check on the two big pharma companies that are going to announce numbers. And we also have an important market expert joining us. After all, it is 11,000 days, isn't it?